So you want to talk about an iconic superhero movie that's beloved by many and talk about it honestly and with criticisms? Come on! Let's get nuts. Batman 1989, for many of the world, was the introduction of the Dark Knight version of Batman. Outside of those who read the comic books, this was the first iteration of Batman that went outside the campy version of Adam West or the Super Friends or stuff like that. I love Adam West and I love the Adam West version for what it is, but this was the first Dark Knight to be brought onto the big screen. Tim Burton's Batman, starring Michael Keaton and Jack Nicholson, is kind of the most basic Batman story because it has the benefit of being first. It's the first on-screen depiction of Bruce Wayne's parents being killed. It's the first on-screen portrayal of the Joker. It's the first brooding, dark, gothic Gotham. I love Batman, and for me, the pinnacle portrayal of Batman and Joker will always be Kevin Conroy and Mark Hamill from the Arkham series of video games and from Batman the Animated Series and from a couple other animated sources where they lend their voices perfectly to those characters. As I'm reading the comics, those are the voices that I'm picturing, and those are the interpretations of those characters that are the most true for me. This version, Batman 1989, Michael Keaton's Batman and Jack Nicholson's Joker, don't exactly fit into what I think of as the, like, perfectly exactly those characters. I watch through this movie and I go, oh, is that, like, does that really work for me? Batman's killing people. Joker's identity is known. Some of it doesn't ring true for me as these being the ideal versions for me. I didn't grow up on this movie. But when I look at this movie as an Elseworlds, as part of the Batman multiverse, a version of Batman and Joker, I start to love and appreciate it a lot more for what this version brings to Gotham and those iconic characters. For one, I think it's the best on-screen Gotham that we've ever gotten. I live-action movie Gotham that we've ever gotten. It doesn't feel like it's shots inside Chicago or New York City or Toronto. It doesn't feel like just a city that you would find in the world. It feels like the Gotham of comic books, like dark with its own kind of weird aesthetic, and I think that's where this movie shines the best, is the visuals and the aesthetics. Of course, adding to the atmosphere is Danny Elfman's iconic score. It's just the definitive Batman score, both in my mind and in probably most of the world's. I mean, his main Batman theme goes on to be the main Batman theme of the animated series. It's just so good and draws you even deeper into this world. But also, while not every part of the characters I think is 100% true, I do love what they do with the characters. While Batman does kill, I also think Michael Keaton's portrayal of Bruce Wayne as just off. He's just awkward and a little bit unhinged, especially in the, come on, punk, you wanna go, moment that he has, but it fits really well for it, for what Bruce Wayne's origin is. And Jack Nicholson's Joker, while, you know, he's not Mark Hamill's Joker, he is something special. He definitely feels like he is pulled right out from the comic books. He's got his comically large gun. He's going around and messing up art. He's killing people with joy buzzers. And he seems like he's just having a great time throughout the whole movie. And he's very fun to watch. I feel like also the performances of Vicki Vale and Alfred need to be mentioned, as they feel like the only two completely normal people in Bruce Wayne's life. And their scenes add a lot of credibility to his characterization, especially Vicki Vale and Bruce on their first date together in Wayne Manor. Just talking, getting to know each other. I really like that scene. But I feel like this movie is a bit unevenly structured in how it tells its story. I should say in how it shows its story. I will, before I dive into criticisms, I will give it more props in that this movie doesn't treat the audience like idiots. There's no, like, big broad speech of, I'm Batman and I must protect the city and this is why I do it. I do it to honor the legacy of my parents. I do it for this, that, and the other thing. And Joker's not, oh, well, Batman, I need to oppose you. I'm the force of chaos. The characters just are what they are. The actors know what they are doing so well that it comes across on screen through the looks that they give, through the glances that they give each other, through their physicality, through their actions, through the way that they're shot. So all of this movie does a lot of its show better than its tell, and it knows it. It focuses on that. But in the way that the story is structured, it is a little weird. We don't actually see Bruce Wayne until like half an hour or so into the movie. We spend a lot more time on Jack Napier, Joker, before he turns into Joker. And then we get Vicki Vale's perspective on coming in to the city, and she goes to Bruce Wayne's party so that way her reporter buddy can talk to the commissioner and get shot down again. I don't know what else he expected. This movie feels like it's more... it's doing two things. It's not telling Batman's story and Joker's story. It's telling Joker's story and the story of Vicki Vale coming into Batman's world. While we do have scenes that are from Batman and Alfred's point of view, they're almost always talking about Vicki Vale or the Joker. There's no... Bruce Wayne as a character himself isn't explored. It's all his relationships to Vicki Vale and Joker, which is fine. Again, I love Michael Keaton's interpretation of Bruce Wayne. It's just, while the first hour or so that I was watching, I was like, this movie's called Batman, right? I feel like we've barely gotten to know Batman. By the end of the movie, I feel like we know him pretty well. But it was a little weird watching through it again and being like, I don't really know much about Bruce Wayne or Batman. They're like kind of there. And then there's also, you know, some plot holes that are just weird that you could spend time talking about. Like, how is it that Bruce Wayne is this massively rich person with a huge mansion and a massive art collection, and he's hosting events for the city that the commissioner and all of these important people and Harvey Dent are showing up to, and nobody knows anything about him. Like, nobody, like, what does he look like? Nobody knows. His parents, for being so rich and influential, were gunned down in the streets, leaving him an orphan, and the killer was never caught. That's a crazy story about this influential and huge family in Gotham, and nobody, like, it's a mystery in the movie that Vicki Vale is like, who is this Bruce Wayne guy? Why is he going to Crime Alley and putting flowers down? Which, like, I don't mind that as a plot point. It's just weird considering how rich and influential Bruce Wayne is portrayed as being. And also, there are just kind of scenes that happen. Most of them are, like, needed, but they come in a weird order, and they're just kind of okay, Joker is doing this now, he's throwing the pen at that guy. Who is that guy? I don't know. But we have to have that scene because it's Joker's introduction to Gotham, and also it lets Bruce Wayne see Joker, and it also lets Vicki Vale see Bruce Wayne's reaction to the violence around him and further build the intrigue of who is this guy, why is he reacting this way. But in terms of this, like, what's actually happening in the scene or why it's happening, I don't really know. And then later on, Bruce Wayne is talking with Vicki and is like, I have to go. And then he goes to Ajax Chemicals and shoots and blows up all of these Joker goons. Batman murdering people with a bomb aside. How did he know that they were there? What were they doing? I mean, we know what they're doing. They were getting the chemicals for the thing, for the parade at the end, but why does Batman know that they're there? Also, then we see Joker hanging from the helicopter going, you missed me, Bat! Blah, 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 blah. And then the next cut, like, it's not even a transition. It's like a cut to then the parade with Joker on a car going through downtown in the parade, and Batman is not there, so this is now a completely different day. I guess Joker completely got away. It was just weird pacing and structural choices, which is not to say that I didn't enjoy this movie, because I did. I really enjoyed going back and rewatching it, actually a little bit more than I remembered myself enjoying this movie and this version of these characters. I was kind of expecting to go back and watch it and be like, yeah, okay, like, I remember all of the big points, like, the iconic moments, and it's, you know, kind of fine. But I enjoyed it a lot more than I remembered myself to enjoy it. Bruna, Catwoman's next movie. I can't talk about her yet. I really enjoy this version of the character. I don't remember Batman Returns very well. I have seen that one far less than I've seen Batman 89, so I'm excited to go back and revisit that movie before The Flash eventually comes out pretty soon, and we get to see Michael Keaton return as Batman. But those were my thoughts upon this reviewing of Batman 1989 for me. Let me know what you think of the movie down below. When was the last time you've watched it? Are you rewatching it in anticipation of seeing Michael Keaton return to the role? What are your thoughts about his interpretation of Batman and Bruce Wayne? Let me know in the comments below. I'd be happy to talk about it. Thank you so much for watching, and have a good week. Catwoman comes next time. I know. Mm-hmm.